Hello children, Sai Ram, welcome back. Now in the previous class, we had finished with the revision of chapter 1. Today let us continue with revision of chapter 2, that is in part 2. Now in chapter 2, that is 4 operations, we have already learned about the basic 4 operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. We have also learned about their properties. So let us take a quick recap of all the basic 4 operations again. Now in chapter 2 we had done addition. We have also learnt about the properties of addition. In subtraction we learned about to carry out the subtraction sum of a 7 and 8 digit numbers and also to find the missing digits. In multiplication and division we have learned how to multiply a number. And then also we have learned about their properties of multiplication as well as division. Now in the Bodmer's rule, we have learned which basic operation to be carried out first according to the Bodmer's rule. Now let us take the first basic operation, that is addition. Now in addition, we have learned that the two numbers which are added are called as addeds. And the answer or the result what we get is called as the sum. Now, let us take a quick recap of the properties of addition. Now, the first property of addition is the order commutative property, which tells us that two numbers can be added in any order, their sum will remain the same. That is, in the example, you can see here, any two numbers, if they are added in any order, the answer or the sum will remain the same. Now the second property is associative property, which tells us that the three numbers can be added in any order, their sum will remain the same. Now here you can see the example, three numbers are given here to be added. If these three numbers are added in any order, their answer or the sum will remain the same, which is called as associative property. Now in the third property is zero identity property, which tells us that when zero is added to a number, the sum is the number itself. To any number, let it be a 7 digit or an 8 digit, if zero is added to any number, the sum or the answer is the number itself. Coming to the next operation, that is subtraction. Now in subtraction we have already learned that the first number or the number from which we subtract is called as the minuend. The second number which is subtracted is called as the subtrahend. The answer or the result after subtracting the two numbers is called as the difference. Now to find out the missing digits, which we already done, that is to find the minuend, the first number you can say you have to add subtrahend to the difference. So when you add the difference plus subtrahend, you will get the minuend. Same way to find the subtrahend or the second number, you have to subtract the difference from minuend. Okay, so to find the subtrahend, minuend minus difference. In multiplication also we have learned that the first number the number to be multiplied is called as multiplicand. The second number, the number by which we multiply, is called as the multiplier, and the answer or the result what we get is called as the product. Now let us see the properties of multiplication. The first property of multiplication is commutative property. Now two numbers can be multiplied in any order, their product will remain the same. It is the same like the property of addition, that is two numbers if it is added in any order, their sum remain the same. Same way for multiplication also, commutative property tells us that two numbers can be multiplied in any order, their product, the answer is called as the product, will remain the same. Coming to the second property, that is associative property, which tells us that three groups can be grouped in any order and then multiplied, their product will remain the same. So three numbers, if it has to be multiplied, if three numbers are to be multiplied, it can be grouped in any order, their product will remain the same. Same way for the distributive property, the product of a number and a sum is equal to the sum of the individual products of the addends and the number. Now here you can see the example, in the bracket two numbers are to be added. So suppose if the product of any number and a sum, it is equal to the sum of the individual products. This number, if you multiply it by the first number and the second number and then after you add it, you will get the same answer. So this property can also be used for more than two addends. Now coming to the fourth property, that is property of zero, which tells us that the product of a number and zero is always zero. For example, any number multiplied by zero is always zero. Now the fifth property tells us that the identity property, that is the product of a number and one, any number multiplied by one is the number itself, where here one is called as the multiplicative identity. Coming to the fourth basic operation, that is division, the number to be divided is called as the dividend. The number by which we divide is called as the divisor. The answer or the result what we get is called as the quotient, or the number which is left at the end is called as the remainder. And to check whether your division is correct, that is, we have got a formula, that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus the remainder. Now coming, let us revise the properties of division. That the first property tells us that any number divided by itself gives 1. So any number, if it is divided by the number itself, the answer will always be 1. Now the second property tells us that any number divided by 1 gives the number itself. That is, any number if you divide it by 1, it will be the number itself. The third property is 0 divided by any number results in 0. That is, if 0 is divided by any number, your answer will always be 0. And the fourth property tells us that a number cannot be divided by 0. So for example, any number cannot be divided by 0, or you can say that it is not defined. Now according to the Bodmer's rule, where we have learned if there are more than 4 basic operations to be done in a sum, according to the Bodmer's rule, it tells us that the brackets are to be solved first. B stands for brackets. O stands for of, that is which you will be learning in the higher classes. D stands for division. M for multiplication. A for addition. And S for subtraction. So according to the rule, we will solve the brackets first. And then starting from left to right, whichever operation comes first, we will do it according to the Bodmer's rule, that is order of operations. Now based on this second chapter, let us solve some sums. The first one is choose the correct option. Now here the first sum is 9356 multiplied by 1000. Now here in multiplication we have already learned that any number if it is multiplied by 10, 100 or 1000, it is followed by the zeros. The number is followed by the zeros. Now here the number is multiplied by 1000. So your answer will be the number itself, 9356, followed by the three zeros. So which is your correct answer? B1. Now coming to the second sum. 37,86,715 plus 21,54,968. Now when you add these two numbers, what is your answer? Now to instead of just adding and seeing, you can add the ones place itself and see. Now here it is 8 and here it is 5. Now what is 8 plus 5? 8 plus 5 is 13. That means in your ones place it should be 3. So, but here in the option, in the second one it is 4 and here it is 5. But here when you add 8 plus 5, that means in the ones place it should be 3. So, which is your correct option? By seeing the number itself, you can make that your correct answer. That is, your option is A1. Okay. Now, dash added to a number is the number itself. According to the property of addition, to any number, what added to a number is the number itself. That is, 0 added to a number is the number itself. To any number, if you add 0, the sum will remain the same. Coming to the next sum, three groups grouped in any order and then multiplied, their product will remain the dash. That is, according to the property of multiplication, we can say that three numbers, if it is grouped in any order and multiplied, their product will remain the same. So your option is the first one. Now coming to the fifth sum, 264 divided by 3 plus 132 minus 108 into 2 plus 100 divided by 20. Now here, according to the Bodmer's rule, we'll solve the brackets first. So when we solve the brackets, here 264 divided by 3, your answer will be, when you solve the brackets, it is 88 plus 132. Now minus, the next bracket is 100 divided by 20. So this will remain the same, that is 108 into 2 plus, now 100 divided by 20 is 5. Now again you will solve the brackets here. When you solve the brackets, 8 plus 132 will give you 220. Now 108 multiplied by 2 will give you 216 plus 5. Now from left to right, whichever is the first operation, that is subtraction. So 220 minus 200 is 4 plus 5, that is equal to 9. So what is your answer? Your option is A1. Correct? Now coming to the sixth one, 5678 divided by 5678. Now according to the property of division, the same number, that is, if a number is divided by the same number, your answer will always be 1. Okay, so your option is the C1. Now click whether true or false. The product of a number and 1 is the number itself. Is it true or false? When you multiply any number, product of the number, into 1, suppose if I take any number, 47 into 1, what will be my answer? My answer is the number itself, that is 47. So what is your option? Your option is true. Okay, now minuend is equal to difference minus subtrahend. Is it true or false? If you want to find the minuend, what is your formula? Your formula is difference plus subtrahend. So here it is difference minus subtrahend. So your answer is false. So read the statement correctly, children, before clicking the correct answer or the option. The third one is, any number can be divided by 0. Is this true or false? Yeah, it is false. A number cannot be divided by 0. So it is false. Coming to the fourth one. To multiply a number by 1000, write the number followed by 2 zeros. That is, if you multiply any number by 1000, Should it be followed by three zeros or two zeros? It should be followed by three zeros, but here it is given as two zeros. So what is your answer? Your answer is false. Now, according to the board marks, we perform multiplication before addition. So according to the board marks rule, multiplication comes first before addition. So your answer is true, that is A1. Okay, coming to the next question, that is solve the following and choose the correct answer. Now here the first one is, children, you have to solve the sum in your rough book, carry out the addition or subtraction, whatever is to be carried out, and then click the correct option. Now here the first sum is 8,12,921 plus 6,15,384. Now when you add these two answers, you will get the answer as 14,28,305. You can just solve in your rough book, write the number like this, 8,12,921 plus you'll add it as 6,15,384. Now when you add these two numbers, you get the 4 plus 1 is 5, 8 plus 2 is 10, 1 carry over, 9 plus 1 is 10, plus 13, 1 carry over, 5 plus 2 is 7, 7 plus 1 is 8, 2 and then 14. So your answer is 14,28,305, that is your, the option is C1. Now 93,876 subtracted from 8,05,346. Now here you have to subtract 93,876 from this one. So which number you will write first? That is 8,05,346 minus 93,876. So 93,876. Now carry out the subtraction. Yes, 6 minus 6 is 0. Yes, now here you will borrow 2, 1 carry over, 14 minus 7 is 7. Again here 4, 1 carry over, 12 minus 8 is 4, 4 minus 3 is 1. Borrow from here, 7, 1, 10 minus 9 is 1 and then 7 here. So your option is the first one, that is A1. Okay, now coming to the third one, 81 divided by 3, divided by 3, divided by 3 and divided by 3. So according to the board mark, solve the bracket first. Now 81 divided by 3 is 27, you'll get, then divided by 3, divided by 3 and then again divided by 3. Now 27 divided by 3 is 9, divided by 3, divided by 3. Now 9 divided by 3 is 3, divided by 3, that is your answer is 1. So which is your option? That is B1. Okay, now here your option was C1. So you have to solve all the sums in your rough book and then click the correct option. Coming to the next sum. Now here in the fourth question, it is 93,87,046 divided by 100 gives dash as remainder. Now we already learned that any number, if it is divided by 10, 100 or 1000, the last number that is in a number, if it is divided by 10, the last number will become your remainder. Now here it is divided by 100, so the last two digit of a number will be your remainder. If it is divided by 1000, so the last three digit will become your remainder. So here if it, as it is divided by 100, 46 will be your remainder. So your option is the C1. Now coming to the fifth sum, 3 into 2 into 24 divided by 6 plus 20 minus 7. So we'll solve according to the board mass rule, we'll solve the division sum first. So that will be 3 into 2 into 24 divided by 6 is 4 minus 20, sorry, plus 20 minus 7. So 3 into 2 is 6 into 4 plus 20 minus 7. So 6 into 4 is 24 plus 20 minus 7. So this will become 44 minus 7. That is equal to 37. So which is your option? Your option is the A1. Now the sixth one is 96,84,325 minus dash will give you 34,32,313. Now here, to find the middle number or to find the subtrahend, the difference has to be subtracted from the minuend. Okay, so you will write the sum here as, you will subtract. So 96 lakh 84,325, you will subtract 34, you will subtract these two numbers, the difference, you write the difference here down, 32,313, that is 34,32,313. When you subtract, 5 minus 3 is 2, 1, 3 minus 3 is 0, 2, 5, 2, and the 9 minus 3 is 6. So which is your option? Your option is the B1. Okay, so here the fourth option was C1, and here your answer was A1. Correct. So what if in the question, if the question is said has solve the following, you have to solve it in your notebook and then click the correct option. Okay, children. So meet you in the next class. We'll do the revision for third chapter in the next class. So enjoy your day till we meet again. Thank you.